Thanks for being a part of this video. This is a pretty fun project for me, and I'm excited to share this process with you. The project that I have here in front of me is one of our ISU alums named Owen Miller, who's an early draft pick of the San Diego Padres, was traded to the Cleveland Indians as part of the Mike Clevenger trade a few summers ago. And through a friend, I reached out to Owen and said, hey, I'm making this video for the ISU alumni engagement group. Owen agreed that I could make him a couple baseball bats and then he would swing those in a batting cage at his minor league baseball training facility in Columbus, Ohio, before he got called up to the Cleveland Indians for his Major League Baseball debut.
Okay, here we go. So we start with a billet, a 3-inch billet of wood. It's rock maple that comes from Maine. I'm trying to draw the center point here that I can put it on the lathe in such a way that it is as centered as possible. So it makes my job easier when I start cutting like I am right here. So I'm using a gouge up against a rest that is locked into place. And you see me chipping away, essentially, you know, cutting away at the maple wood. You see down at the bottom of your screen, the wood is a little bit kind of jumpy down there because it hasn't been centered yet. Up at the top, what I'm trying to do is center the wood so that when I start shaping it, that it's already centered, and the bat then, when you grab it, it has a center of gravity. It feels good in your hand. The rest that you see here moving around, and I'm locking it into places so that I can push the gouge up against it. My job is to kind of continue to use the calipers, look at the Rawlings big stick that I'm using. You see it sitting on top of the trash can there. So what you see here is me kind of continuing to try to shape the bat. Now, obviously down here, you'll see that I'm going to make the bat kind of move a little bit less. You know, right now it's jumpy. And what I'm going to do is I'm marking to show you where 33.5 inches is, because Owen, you know, let me know that he needs a 33.5 inch bat. He told me the length, he told me the weight he wants it to be. Well, it's been a little while since I made this, but I think he wanted it to be about a drop three. So 33.5 ounce bat. So I'm using the calipers to get down to where the handle of the bat is. So where I'm cutting now is gonna be the handle, right? So there's a lot more that needs to be cut there than there would be up by the barrel. But this is good maple pro grade wood that I get from Maine. This is pretty easy, as you can see, with one gouge tool, I'm able to take a lot of wood that just can, it's funny because a lot of it's, you know it's maple because it sticks to my shirt. So it's one of those dry fit shirts, my ISU art shirt, you know, a lot of the maple sticks to my arm, it sticks to my shirt. Other types of wood may not exactly do that, but this coming off of a lathe does. So you see, I kind of found based on the calipers there, I found, okay, this is going to be the thickness of the end of the handle, and then I'm gonna shape the bat accordingly. You're seeing me here kind of shape the handle. You see the knob on the end, and now I'm kind of winnowing the handle down. It's still very thick. I'm testing the calipers to figure out if I've got the handle right. So I'm looking both at that homewood bat, which is a shorter bat, but that's really the handle that I'm trying to model the bat off. It's a more contemporary handle. The Rawlings bat's more than 10 years old. That's what I'm kind of looking at for the barrel of the bat. So really you go through with the lathe and you've seen various cutting tools that I've used. Some are more detailed than others. And then soon enough here, I'm going to jump in with a sander. So I'll put a sandpaper on the end of a drill and start going through that as well. But in this environment, I really need to make sure that I'm sanding or that I'm cutting the bat down into the right shape, because soon enough, I'm gonna take the bat off, put it on a scale. And if I haven't cut it down enough, then the bat's gonna be too heavy for the baseball player. So you really wanna, you know, the test is both, will the ball jump off the bat and not break, as well as will the bat, you know, be the right length weight ratio that we're looking for. So now I'm right there on the handle and I'm trying to figure out, if my bat that I've made matches up. So now I still got to shave a little bit more off of that. So it's this constant back and forth. The more you make the bats, the more you trust your eyes. So here we are, we've got a corded drill. On the end of that is a circular piece of sandpaper. So basically when I sand, I'm turning up the lathe so it goes twice as fast as it does when I cut. And I'm also putting my drill on the highest speed available to me. And right now I'm working with a 60 grit sandpaper, and I'm really just trying to push against the wood, the maple, and I'm trying to shave it off. So there's two parts. I'm trying to continue to shape the bat, but obviously it's going to shape it more slowly than it would with the gouge. And at the same time, I'm going to try to smooth the bat out. So you'll see various, I start with 60, I might go to 120 or 150, and then I'll end at like 220 or 240 on my grades of sandpaper here. And again, you know, it takes a while. There's not much cutting of this video. I'm really showing you the mess that it makes. You know, if you look at all the wood chips everywhere, it's kind of a fun process. You look at my shirt and it already has not just the wood chips all over it, but now the sawdust that I'm creating. So this is kind of what the space looks like. Those are the billets. That's kind of the mess here. I've got the wood, I'm looking at it. All right, 31.66. I needed to get this thing down to about 31 and I think it's 31. So I'm gonna be able to take off the rest of that weight when I cup it a little bit later. So I put the bat back onto a lathe where it's much easier for me to paint the bat. I basically just put the brush down and let the bat spin so that the bat gets an even coat of paint. Believe it or not, when I originally made Owen's bat, I didn't take videos of me painting it. So this is me painting a different bat where it's black on the bottom and then red on top. But really what we're looking at is the wood spins. I put the paint on it at the 17 inch mark, really. So you see where the black hits the red, that's the spot where pine tar can't get above it. So on top of the paint, after I put a couple coats of paint down, I put what's called Crystallac exterior clear gloss over it. I put three coats of that down. So you can see that this is good for exterior. It helps keep the paint on the bat and not on the baseballs. You're also gonna see in there, you can see right where I'm painting now, I have a sticker there because Major League Baseball ensures that the wood grain is correct and is straight and really, really straight. So I put a circular sticker on there, peel it off, and I put like an ink dot test on there, which is what Louisville Slugger, Marucci, you know, Old Hickory, Homewood Bats, and a lot of the other bat makers across the country do. So I put three coats of this down, and it's gloss, which really makes the color stand out. So for Owen, what I gave him two bats. One is all black. Another one, there's red on it, and that was kind of like an extra bat that I wanted to give to him so I could engrave the Reggie Redbird head in there as well. So once this is done, I put it back on the scale and say, okay, where am I? Do I have the right shape, etc.? So you see the sticker in there that they're actually spice stickers for my spice rack. And we've got that we're down at like 31.1. so what I need to do is use this. It's basically a drill bit, but it's horizontal. And I'm gonna cut down to get to the right weight. So I've done this enough to know how much I need to cut into the end of the bat to cup the bat. So cupping the bat does a few things. It takes weight off, but it also lowers the center of gravity. Here I am using the laser engraver. We use this for graphic design, expanded media. And Brian Franklin, the associate professor of art, he's taught me how to use this. He's a great colleague who's like, sure, let me teach you how to do this. So the bat's 33 and a half inches, 31 ounces. This was the MW is me. I'm Mike Wille. Year is 21. And that this is the 22nd bat of the year that I've made in 2021. And again, it's pro grade rock maple. So now I'm gonna show you how I peel it when it was the black bat that I made for Owen. So I made him again, two, a black one and the red one. You gotta peel off all the tape out of there to make sure that, you know, when you fill in those areas with paint, that you end up with paint, not blue, you know, tape. So once this all comes out, then what I'll do is fill those areas in with paint, which again, me being the painter, this shouldn't be too much of a problem. But again, it's kind of a fun process. You can pick any colors that you want because Owen is a Redbird and we're super proud of him, especially now that he's a Major League Baseball player. So here I am, I'm filling it in with gold, and now I'm kind of, because it's sunken in there, you see the silver on one side, the gold on the other, and you see the tape mark there to indicate 17 inches. So there you go.
Hey, what's up? My name is Owen Miller. I'm a middle infielder in the Cleveland Indians organization. I play college ball at Illinois State from 2016 to 2018. And I just want to thank Mike Wille for sending me a couple bats. Go Redbirds.